Welcome to the Trading with a Bot channel. In today's video, I would like to show you how to expand the tiny Doge bot that I introduced to you in the beginning of June. Since the 4th of June, this bot had already made over $35 in net income. The tiny Doge is a DCA bot, and it is the most profitable when the price is very volatile. Here on June 21st, the bot had made $9.62. But I had to increase my maintenance balance from 25 USDT to 50 USDT, so that I will not get liquidated, with the sharp declines in price that happened on that day. What's positive, however, is that the bot's settings had always allowed it to exit with a profit, even on such sharp declines that we have seen last week. I had provided an extensive explanation of the settings of this bot in my last three videos, and so if you haven't seen them, I encourage you to pause this video and watch the other ones first. These settings that I had discovered for Dogecoin bot are also working for other coins, and I am about to show this. I will go back now to the strategy backtester created by Ruam and enter the settings that I am using. Note that I'll put some arbitrary number for my base order and safety order sizes. For example, I will put $25. This backtest is not designed to calculate the profit for futures platform, considering the leverage, and thus, for me it is not important to recreate the exact amounts I am trading with. What will be important is to see how the net profit changes when I modify the settings. And so, in other words, I use the net profit figure as a benchmark of the settings, not as an exact forecast of how much money I will make. 2.7, 0.1.9, 0.7, I already remember these values by heart. Watch how the net profit changes when I modify one of these settings. Increasing the safety order volume scale will always increase the net profit, but it is not the case with the other two. The price deviation percent and the safety order step scale. Here, when I increase or decrease them from my default values, the profit drops. So I will change them back to 2.7, 0.1.9, and 0.7. And we will go in to test some other coins with these particular settings. Note this vertical menu bar on the right hand side. I will click on the very first icon here, called Watch Lists and Details. Here you can see a custom watch list that I created for myself, called Binance Futures. This way I see all the contracts that are tradable on the futures platform, and I can add new ones manually when Binance adds them to their platform. TradingView is incredibly flexible, allowing its users to organize and monitor all kinds of financial assets. And here's how I go about creating a new list. Try it as well. Creating such a watch list will help us to backtest some of the other coins incredibly fast. Click on Create New List, and give it a descriptive name. I'll just call it Test. Now I will click on the plus icon, and start adding coins into my newly created watch list. Here just type in the crypto pair you're looking for, and click on plus. On Binance Futures, the quote currency is USDT, so I am adding Doge USDT, BTC USDT and .USDT. So this is how you go about creating your own watch list. Let me switch to my existing list, where I already have around 100 pairs added. You see that it is conveniently showing the current price of the coin, and the 24-hour price change. But also I can just click on any of them, and the coin's chart will be loaded. Thus, it will be easy to jump from coin to coin, and backtest the settings. Let's change the time interval for 15 minutes, this is what the script developer had recommended we use. And now, I will click on one coin at a time. The backtester settings stay the same, but because the price of the coins behave differently, we will see different net profit results. In other words, the settings that I used for Tiny Doge may or may not produce the same results for other coins, and I will be looking for coins where the results will be similar or better. I've noted that with the given funding and for the specific backtest window, the net profit for Doge was $205 or 82%. And so 82% of net profit is now my benchmark value. I will go through the coins on my watch list and see if any of them provide a similar return value. When I click on the coin from my watch list, the chart loads, and the backtester script calculates the return. I am looking for something around 80% of net profit, or above. As you can see, The performance of Dogecoin is difficult to beat. Here, Cody comes close. And also Dentcoin has 78% return. There will be a few other coins that backtest very well against the settings we discussed, and when you discover them, please do leave a comment below. So now, I am on the chart for Dentcoin, and what I want to do is to see if the 2.7, 1.9 and 0.7 settings are indeed produce the highest return for Dent. It is very possible that this coin may return a higher return, if I change one of these settings, so that is what I plan to check now. As I explore the settings, I see that Dent's price was probably behaving much like Doge's, because the net profit is indeed the highest, with the settings that I used for the tiny Doge bot. I tweak around other settings, out of curiosity, but then I put them all back in. Keep in mind that many of these settings impact the budget requirements of the bot. For example, if I increase the number of the safety orders, I will potentially increase the size of the position that the bot will open when the price goes down. You are certainly welcome to adapt and customize your tiny bots in any way you can. I just want to make sure you understand the implications of these settings. In a moment, I will go over the budget calculator for the tiny Dent bot that we're about to build. Before I use the calculator, I examine the coin's price movements in the last days. I see a straight drop of 9%, and a bit earlier on I see a 19% drop. I also try to see by what percent the price had recovered after the drop. These are just random sampling. I cannot make any rules from such a quick review, although I should certainly anticipate such similar drops in the future. Now, I will use the anti-liquidation calculator that I had presented to you earlier. You'll find all of the links below and in the video description section. Here I choose the Dent coin, keep my base order and safety order sizes equal to 5, and set the leverage to 50. Next, I'll adjust the safety order settings to match exactly the settings that I had on my backtest. 2.7, 1.9, 0.7, and just as with the tiny Doge bot, I can see that these settings will handle a drop of 12.94%, and that my budget requirements are $21.86. Note that the safety order settings will only cover the fall of 7.94%, and then we will need to wait for the price to recover in order to exit the position. In my experience so far, these settings and the 6 safety orders were sufficient for the Dogecoin. Here we can specify an additional fall that the price may take. An additional 10% to the already specified safety order range of 7.94% will give us a coverage of 17.94%. Most importantly, this calculator tells us the balance you need to maintain on your futures account to handle such a price fall. If I have less than $35.29, I will be liquidated. Here the calculator even provides the price level at which your position will be liquidated. It is $0.0019. If I were to increase my balance to 50 USDT, I would not get liquidated with a 17% fall, but there would still be a liquidation price, and it is shown here. There is always a liquidation risk associated with trading on futures and using high leverage. Now, as I understand the risks associated with this bot, I will go back to the 3Commas website and set it up. I can set it up from scratch or copy an existing bot. I press the copy button on my tiny Doge bot and go into the edit mode. I'll call it a tiny Dent. And since I've copied the settings from the tiny Doge, the only change I need to make is the crypto pair. Now I will have two bots running under my futures account, and for this, I would like to consider isolating the balance between the bots. I have 50 USDT on my account now, and if I used cross leverage, I would have shared this balance between both of them. So, instead, I choose isolated. There is one issue that I have, however. I cannot specify the amount I want to isolate. Let's start this bot now and look at it from Binance interface. The Dent bot had opened a position alongside of my tiny Doge bot. Note that my Doge bot was specified to use the cross leverage, and the Dent bot I had just started with the isolated leverage setting. The issue here is that Binance had assigned my isolated budget to be extremely small, only 10 cents, and I am already above 55%. If I do not increase the balance I want to allocate to this bot, I will run out of the allocated budget, and Binance will automatically close my position. By clicking on the pencil icon next to the margin amount, I am able to add funds to the isolated margin amount. Unfortunately, I had to do this manually. And what's worse, this is completely impractical when using automated bots. Our tiny DCA bot will continue to buy and sell new positions, and I cannot adjust its budget manually every time a new position is created. If you are aware of a better method of setting the preferences for isolated margin amounts, please do let me know. I had found how to overcome this issue by using another major crypto exchange platform called FTX.com. FTX is similar to Binance, but it has a few unique features, such as sub-accounts, which will allow its users to isolated budgets in a flexible and a secure way. Additionally, there are a few more financial instruments that are available on FTX that are not available on Binance, and I already started two types of experiments which I will share with you in my next video. First, I will continue to show you other volatile coins that you can apply the tiny Doge setting, with even smaller budget, and even higher net profit. And second, we will talk about the hedge mode, running both long and short DCA bot at the same time, on the same coin contract. It is very exciting, and I cannot wait to share with you my findings. Before I close today, I'd like to ask you for a favor. If you do not have an FTX account, and are planning to open one, please use my referral code that I list below. With this, I will get a small commission from your trading volume, and you will receive a 5% discount off your trading fees. It is a win-win for both of us, and it will continue to encourage me to share with you my best strategies, so that we both benefit. Thank you, until next time.